Right now, there are 1,500 Ontarians waiting for an organ transplant, and sadly, every 3 days, someone on that waiting list dies.
And one of the problems, only 17% of us here in Ontario have actually registered. No excuses anymore. It's an easier way to do it. You're about to tell us about.
Right. It's point and click. So there's no more lining up at a kiosk, no more printing out and mailing forms. You just need a computer and your health card, and you can sign up to save a life, even 8 lives, in under a minute.
My children couldn't have given me this. They did, and I don't even know them.
Carol is a double lung recipient. Andrea needed a new heart.
We didn't know how long we had. We didn't know what was going to happen in our future. So he said that he knew he wanted to spend whatever time we had with me.
Andrea collapsed at her own wedding.
Oh my God!
Then just last December, when Andrea received her new heart, Global Television was there.
Hey, the heart's here.
14-year-old Sarah Marshall was just 5 months old when she became the youngest ever recipient of a stomach, pancreas, liver, and bowel transplant. Lives saved because strangers donated organs. Now the province of Ontario has made registering to be an organ donor as easy as point and click.
You'll be asked for your OHIP number and your date of birth.
Then you decide what you'd like to donate and review it.
If you're satisfied, you can officially give your consent.
When Janine Thompson's father fell ill, she wasn't sure of his exact wishes.
I think it's very important to have something like this today where we can see a signature, see something that says this is what your dad, you know, would have wanted.
His donation saved at least 3 lives.
When I see Andrea and people like her, I know that we did, as a family, make the right decision.
And keep in mind, you're never too old to donate. An 89-year-old woman was a recent lung donor, and you can donate tissues right into your 90s. And that green card that you fill out when you renew your driver's license doesn't mean you're actually registered with the province. And if you're not sure, you can check it out on the website. We have a link for you at globaltoronto.com.